everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Perry Plays. Perry Plays is a series where I'm going to be playing through several games, whatever games I fancy, new games, old games, whatever, as long as I can record it. Going to give you a bit of backstory, but before I do that, let's press start so this doesn't cycle round again. But let's just enjoy a bit more of the title music that we all know and love from Pokémon. Anyway, that's enough of that. Start. Ah, yes, because I haven't started before, we've got this stuff, which is perfect, because I want to tell you a bit of backstory. I used to do, or I did on another channel, a Perry Plays Pokémon FireRed before. I didn't get all the way through, because I changed laptops, the recording wouldn't work, and various problems meant I couldn't keep recording. I've still got that save, so I could go back to it. But I was considering whether I could just load those ones up. But decided not to, because I watched them again and they were rubbish. So I'm starting again. And I think that's a good decision on my part. Okay. Without further ado, let's get into the world of Pokémon. In the world which you are about to enter, you will embark on a grand adventure with you as the hero. I don't know if anyone actually read this before, but this is probably one of the first times I've read this stuff at the beginning of the game. Speak to people and check things wherever you go, be it towns, roads, or caves. Gather information and hints from every source. Little bobbing Pikachu on the top left. New paths will open to you by helping people in need, overcoming challenges, and solving mysteries. So you're a charity spy challenge person, I guess. At times, you will be challenged by others and attacked by wild creatures. Be brave and keep pushing on. Just gonna put it out there. You're gonna get attacked by wild creatures. But it's cool, it's cool. Just don't worry about it. What? Okay, next. Through your adventure, we hope that you will interact with all sorts of people and achieve personal growth. That is our biggest objective. Now that is interesting. Because right there is Nintendo's statement, or Game Freak, or whoever actually made this at the time. That's their statement about the game. If Peter had read that, then maybe they wouldn't, No, they'd still be all uptight because it's Peter, for God's sake. Press the A button and let your adventure begin! Let's hit A. Pow! Yeah! Anyone who's played Pokémon, this brings back so many memories, especially for me. I remember getting the first Pokémon. I had Pokémon Red, my brother had Blue. But I remember very little about these games, and I wanted to choose FireRed because it looks better and it's a bit more interesting, got a few more features and stuff. And I thought that'd just make for a more interesting series. But here we are, Professor Oak. And of course I haven't changed the text speed, so it's all slow, so I gotta hold down the A button. Okay. Welcome to the world of Pokémon. My name is Oak. People are affectionately blah, 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 blah. People affectionately refer to me as the Pokémon Professor. I'm not gonna try doing the voice from the TV series. It's inhabited far and wide by creatures called Pokémon. And a little Nidoran female down there. Going, Nidoran female, For some people, Pokémon are pets. Others use them for battling. As for myself, I study Pokémon as a profession. Get back in your ball, you little shit. But first, tell me a little about yourself. Here we go. Okay, now tell me, are you a boy or are you a girl? Professor Oak left his glasses at home, so he can't tell what we are. I am a boy. Let's begin with your name. What is it? Well, let's just go ahead and call myself Perry. in honor of the Perry plays.
Okay.
Right, so your name is Perry.
Yes.
Oh. Okay. His grandson. Now, there's a thing that I probably want to do with Perry plays, and that's if I have a nemesis, I'm going to call them all the same name, so I've got this same recurrent character chasing me through these games, thwarting my attempts.
So, this is my grandson. He's been your rival since you both were babies.
Stealing my, like, dummies or pacifiers for the American fans there.
What was his name now?
Now, Green, Gary, Kaz, or Toru? I assume Toru was the name he had in the Japanese series? I don't know. Most people choose Gary, but the name that I choose for all of these characters is going to be B.A. Not Q.
Why? Barry. Was it Barry?
Yes.
Barry is my nemesis. His name is Barry, and he is a total douche nozzle.
Perry, your very own Pokemon legend is about to unfold. A world of dreams.
Am I going slightly Bane with Professor Oak's voice? I don't know. Maybe I should hold a cup up to my voice and try that.
Hello, I'm Professor Oak. You merely inherited the Pokemon. I was born in it, molded by it.
I don't know how that's going to be picked up by the mic, but I hope that came out okay. So, here we are, Pokemon FireRed. I'm doing my little victory dance of starting my adventure. And one of the first notable differences is this is the NES. Was it a NES in the original game? Might have been in 64. I'm probably very wrong. I'm going to throw it out right now that I remember very little about these games. So I'm going to be getting stuff wrong. This is not a how-to or really a let's play because they're at least partly informational. This is just Rich Perry playing some games, getting shit wrong, having a blast.
In bed. Ugh.
Fall out of bed. Pfft. And being very immature. So, if I remember right, if I boot up the PC, in the item storage, there's a potion. And it's always a good idea to take that, just in case you struggle with the first battle. But before we do anything else, let's go into the options. No. Oh, god damn it. Fast. There we go. Battle scenes on. Battle style shift. Yeah, that's fine. Sound mono. Yeah, let's keep it authentic. Button mode help. Lure. La. Let's keep it on help. And the frames. What frames have we got? Oh, the really old school frames. That's awesome. Orange is my favourite colour, but doesn't really go with the whole aesthetic. So, god, there's some horrible ones in here. Let's stick with the original one. Okay, that'll do. So, let's embark on our adventure. What's this? It's a posted notice. If you're confused, ask for help. Press the L or R button. I will never use those because I think it's going to be more fun for me to flounder and not know than ask for help. Hello, Mum.
Right, all boys leave home someday. It said so on TV.
Well, that's lovely. You follow the advice that TV gives you.
Oh, yes, Professor Oak next door is looking for you.
So this is my mum, who is perfectly fine with me, a 10-year-old child, going out and embarking on a life-changing adventure. There's a movie on TV. Four boys are walking on the railroad tracks. I better go too. Poignant. Very poignant. Dishes and plates neatly lined up, yeah. Mum keeps a tight ship. She better. Yeah? Okay, that's enough, it's not really spousal abuse. It smells delicious, somebody's been cooking here, yep. Again, with the gender stereotypes. No idea what happened to my dad, but, suppose we just gotta live with that. And here we are, we have Pallet Town. I love how it's my house and not my mum's house. Surely, as I don't own the house, it should be my mum's house. Unless this is some weird reverse world where the youth have all the power and are able to buy property and the elders just... I don't know! That's one of the weird things about the Pokemon universe. The young characters can do all these things, but you hardly ever see, like, adults doing much aside from in corporations or running gyms. And same here, Barry's house. This isn't Barry's house. I would assume that unless he's rich from inheriting things from his grandfather, he shouldn't be able to own this house. Anyway, let's go in. Let's check up, see if Barry's in. Who's this? Daisy. My brother Barry is out at Grandpa's lab. Oh, fair enough. Okay, so... Now, why couldn't you be up against Daisy? There's a interesting thing. It's a big map of the Kanto region. Now, this would be useful. And so I just take it and run. Oh, I can't take it and run. Lame. There's a Pokemon on TV. It looks like it's having fun. Well, that's lovely. Not only are Pokemon being forced to fight for our amusement, they're also being forced to perform on TV. Ethics. is that right? All these people have useless information if you've already played the Pokemon games, but for any noobs, press start to open the menu. Wow. I never would have guessed. Thank you so much. carrying on. But every town seems to have a fat guy. Don't know why. I mean, I'm sure in real life there seem to be, like, fat people in every town. I don't know, but it's Pokemon. And there only seem to be, like, 5 people per town, and one of them is always fat. It's just weird to me. Technology is incredible. You can now store and recall items and Pokemon as data via PC. Now that's kind of terrifying, that you can download an organic being and change it into data. But anyway, Professor Oak's AIDS. So many bad jokes about Professor Oak's AIDS, but South Park's already made them all. So let's carry on. Professor Oak may not look like much, but he's the authority on Pokemon. Many Pokemon trainers hold him in high regard, and that is true throughout pretty much all of the Pokemon games. But, it's Barry. Hello, Barry, you bastard. What, it's only Perry, Gramps isn't around. Oh, you... I hate you so much, Barry. I'm gonna slap you in the face. Tsh! Take that. You know, what are you gonna do with your stupid spiky haircut? Nothing! Nothing at all. Yeah. And these are the Pokemon that you will eventually choose. And I can't actually look at what they are. Damn, I was hoping I'd get a sneak preview. But, I suppose as there's nothing left to do, we shall venture out into the dangerous, dangerous grass. Ooh.
Hey, wait, don't go out!
Yes, wild Pokemon live in tall grass. Here's Professor Oak with Professor Oak's awesome theme tune. You need Pokemon for your protection, because Pokemon act as personal bodyguards. Here, come with me. And we're led by the legend that is Professor Oak into his lab. And I have no choice but to follow him.
Grams, I'm fed up with waiting. I hate you so much, Barry.
Barry?
Let me think.
Oh, that's right, I told you to come.
Sorry. I've spent far too long on the internet. I'm so sorry. Here, Perry. 3 Pokemon here. Ha-ha! What was the ha-ha for? The Pokemon are held inside these Pokeballs. Yep. Now that's the thing. He says he was a serious trainer when he was younger. I'm intrigued. Should there be a prequel Pokemon game where you play as Professor Oak. That would be awesome. Can you imagine being the young Oak and finding out like what his first name is? And Nintendo or Game Freak, get on that, because that's an amazing idea. Like, what did they do before the Pokédex and before Pokéball? Do it. Do it. This is an amazing idea. But anyway, I'm getting distracted. Now, we get to choose our Pokémon. So let's have a look at what they are. The Bulbasaur. It's very easy to raise. No, not yet. I'm just showing the Pokémon available. Squirtle! Little water turtle bastard. I wasn't really fond of Squirtle when I was younger. And Charmander. Charmander's adorable. It's a little lizard with fire on its tail. But no, I really like Bulbasaur. Now, I know I'm going to get a lot of flack for choosing Bulbasaur, but I don't care, because I love Bulbasaur. Bulbasaur is my homie. He was the first Pokemon I ever chose, and he's the Pokemon I'm going to go with right now. So, I do want to go with the grass Pokemon, Bulbasaur. He's quite energetic. Ah, that's good. Victory! And yes, I will be giving nicknames to all of my Pokemon, but they're not going to be stupid nicknames like you get from people you trade with. I'm going to try and inject a bit of humour. So I'm going to call my Bulbasaur A-L-A-N. Alan. Excuse me, Alan. So, Alan is my first Pokemon. Alan the Bulbasaur. And of course, Barry's going to be a complete dick and take the Charmander. Ugh. No, don't play the victory music for him, he's a shit. Let's talk to you. My Pokemon looks a lot tougher than yours. Oh, fuck off, Barry. Seriously, shut up. What do you have to say, Professor Oak? Your Pokemon can battle it. With it at your side, you should be able to reach the next town. Now, there's another thing. People are essentially trapped in their local towns if they don't have Pokemon. How do people get anywhere? You only see, like, two cars in the Pokemon series, or at least in this game. How do people get places without Pokemon? Like, my mum is essentially trapped in this town, and that's kind of terrifying. But anyway, let's go. Oh. Yeah. Alright, Barry. Yes, fine. Here is your first Pokemon battle, and it's with Barry. Rival Barry. Now, there's a thing to be said about Rival Barry, in that, Barry is really Oak going to explain things, but Barry is really the only rival you get in the Pokemon games where he actually doesn't like you. Like, he's actually actively trying to thwart your plans. Otherwise, you've just got friends who want to challenge you, see how you've grown and stuff, but Barry is one of the only rivals who actually tries to get in your way and doesn't like you. You hate Barry, which is fantastic. I love it. They need more rivals like that, and not just from, like, Team Rocket, Team Magma, Team Precum, whoever's going against you at the moment. But anyway, first battle against Barry. You got Fight, Bag, Pokemon, and Run. You can't run from trainer battles. See? So, of course, you only know Tackle and Growl. I hardly ever use attacks like Growl and Leer and stuff, so I'll just be going straight ahead and hitting Tackle. Inflicting damage on foes, key to any battle. Oh, you don't say. And he's got Scratch. Now, luckily, Alan is somehow quicker than Charmander, not entirely sure how. But since I've gone first, I should be able to win this without... Okay, nope. Spoke too quickly. I was going to say, I should be able to win this without using that potion. But, yes, yes. God damn it, Oak, just let me heal my Pokemon. There we go. Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. So, let's see if I can win this. Should be another two tackles? Maybe three. Come on. One more. Yeah! Suck on that Barry, you bastard. I gained 69 experience points. He should level up. Sweet. Sweet. Take that, Barry.
What? Unbelievable. Inconceivable.
I picked the wrong Pokemon. Oh, shut up, Barry. And of course, I extort him out of money, which is the Pokemon way. There you go, kids. You fight people and take their Poke-yen.
Excellent.
If you win, you earn prize money and your Pokemon will grow. So, gambling and fighting with animals, that's what Pokemon promotes. Okay, I'll make my Pokemon battle to toughen it up. Perry, Grabs, smell you later. Oh, sod off, Barry, just go. Ugh. Raise your young Pokemon by making it battle. It has to battle for it to grow. I was wondering why you couldn't just swipe the Squirtle right now, just like... Check he's not looking. Check again. And... Take and go! Aww. Nope, okay. But anyway, we have officially started our Pokemon journey. Let's go visit Mum. Because Mum acts as a Pokemon Center for some reason. I don't really know how she heals Pokemon, but she does. Awesome. And of course, she doesn't care that we've now got a Pokemon and are venturing out into tall grass to fight other Pokemon. Now let's see if this girl will give us that map. Ah, yes. I kicked his ass. I'm doing a little victory dance right now. Nope, I'm not. I'm just moving. Damn. Let's try that again. Victory dance! Victory dance! There we go. Now, how long has this been going? You know what? I'm going to call it there. I'm going to wait right outside of this house. My house. Because I own it for some reason. And I'm going to ask you guys to tune in next time for part 2 of Perry Plays Pokemon FireRed, where we head to the next town, the name of which I can't remember. So, let's see where this takes us. I will see you guys later.